Hey, it's Dan Zimmerman. Welcome to Illustrate to Educate. Don't forget to subscribe for weekly objective videos on topics that matter. In this special edition of Illustrate to Educate, we are going to look at five facts you probably didn't know about the role of the President of the United States. Before we look at the five things you probably didn't know, let's briefly look at what you might already know. The President of the United States is both the head of state and the head of government of the United States of America and Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces. Under Article 2 of the Constitution, the President is responsible for the execution and enforcement of the laws created by Congress. There are 15 executive departments who are each led by an appointed member of the President's Cabinet who carry out the day-to-day administration of the federal government along with the other agencies too. The President also has the power to either sign legislation into law or to veto bills enacted by Congress, although Congress may override a veto with a two-thirds vote of both houses. Although that's not everything the President does, let's get into some of the more unique aspects of the role. Fact number one. You've probably heard of Air Force One, the aircraft that the President uses to travel long distance. But did you know that there are actually two identical airplanes that are used as Air Force One? For travel within the United States, typically only one airplane is used. But for overseas trips, they bring both planes and have one as backup. Interestingly enough, the name of Air Force One actually applies to any U.S. Air Force aircraft the President is aboard for the duration of the flight. So at times, the President will use a smaller Air Force aircraft for smaller airports. Fact number two. It may not be new to you that the President receives a salary, but did you know that currently the President's salary is at its lowest point since it was established back in 1789 when you consider inflation? In 1789, the salary for the President was $25,000, which in today's currency would be about $740,000. The salary reached its peak in 1909 when the salary was at $75,000, which is equivalent to a whopping $2.14 million in today's money. Since that time, it has trended downward to today's salary of $400,000 in 2020. However, since 2001, the salary has included a $50,000 allowance for expenses, $100,000 for travel, and $19,000 for entertainment. Fact number three. When you think about where the President lives, the White House most likely pops in your mind as the official residence of the President. Every president since John Adams in the year 1800 has lived there, but did you know that at various times in U.S. history, it has been known by other names? This includes the President's Palace, the President's House, and the Executive Mansion. It didn't officially become the White House until Theodore Roosevelt officially gave the White House its current name in 1901. But the President also has other residences, like Camp David, a place of solitude and tranquility. It is a mountain-based military camp in Maryland that is often used to host foreign dignitaries since 1940. Fact number four. Did you know that traditionally, the outgoing president gives advice to their successor during the presidential transition? Presidents like Ronald Reagan and his successors have also left a private message on the desk of the Oval Office on Inauguration Day for the incoming president. It's also interesting to note that there's a term for the outgoing president, or any politician really, called a lame duck. A lame duck is often seen as having less influence with other politicians due to the limited time left in office. Fact number five. The final fact about the president has to do with code names. The U.S. Secret Service is charged with protecting the President and the First Family. As part of their protection, presidents, first ladies, and their children, and other immediate family members are assigned Secret Service code names. The use of such names was originally for security purposes and dates to a time when sensitive electronic communications were not encrypted. Today, the names simply serve for purposes of brevity, clarity, and tradition. The White House Communications Agency maintains a list that candidates choose from, and traditionally, all family members' code names start with the same letter and must be easily pronounced and readily understood. Did you enjoy this video about the President of the United States? Please like and share the video, subscribe to Illustrate to Educate, and comment on your thoughts about these and other less known facts about the role of the President of the United States. And don't forget to check out some of my other videos to the right.